this was a hell of a story. The police steal a protester's car, according to the protester. Here's the video.
They're in your car? So they're stealing her car?
After speeding off and driving like they stole it, because they basically did, they drive the car to the parking lot of a school, block off an entrance, and box the stolen car in with their cruisers, putting the car out of view. I don't know about you, but if my car was being towed and the police were involved, I certainly wouldn't want the cops moving my vehicle from its original location without my consent or getting inside my vehicle at all with the possibility of them tampering with or planning God knows what before the tow truck even arrives, especially when they didn't provide any paperwork documenting literally any of this.
What is wrong with people?
Like, you just took their car and now they about to try to run off. Y'all bitch ass. Now y'all want to run off. Now y'all want to run off. Get that girl her car back. Get that girl her car back.
She got kids.
Get that girl that car back. Y'all just gonna leave that girl stranded at the Circle K. Get that girl that car back. Get that girl that car back.
Give her
her car back. Y'all can't take that girl's car. Now y'all gonna run that man over.
You can't take that man.
You can't take that man.
After a wild goose chase, or should I say a wild hog chase, the cops are found in a third location with not one, not two, but three of our activist vehicles, and they're making multiple arrests, one being of a 14-year-old child.
Targeting activists. Beautiful. Yeah. Took an oath to uphold the Constitution.
Are you
here
spitting on? Let her go! Let her go! That is a child! You're abducting a child!
For a police department that is supposedly understaffed and stretched thin, the Akron Police Department sure does have enough resources to harass, intimidate, and retaliate against community activists and organizers who've done nothing but try to hold them accountable to the bare minimum standard of not murdering people. Just
that's insane, is it not? Shocking. Something like that would happen to anyone in this country. Shocking that any law enforcement agency would engage in such conduct, right? All right, so allegedly, this was during a protest over the killing of Jalen Walker. He was unarmed. They decided to release a firestorm of bullets into his body, okay? It hit him over 40 times. Those bullets ravished his body. He should not have died. He should not have been shot. He should not have been killed. The people were protesting a righteous protest. I have never seen cars being stolen by the police. Never seen that before. That's a new one. Let's put up the chief. Buck stops with him. He's the man in charge now. Corruption is especially high under this particular chief. His name is Stephen Milet. Okay. He's the chief of Bellevue Prior to Akron. And he is a significant reason why you have things unchecked in the police department. In a survey conducted by the city, more than half of the respondents say they felt less safe than before. This is what policing looks like under him. All right. Okay. Obviously, more information needs to come. We're trying to get more information, establish more information. If you have that, make sure you get in touch with us at Indisputable. Jeff, thoughts on this?
Yeah, you know, floating around Ohio, there's a bunch of videos of these same police, the same police department in Akron, macing individuals and pepper spraying individuals who seem to be peacefully protesting. I'll put that seam out there just in case there's something I missed in video. But there's a lot going on in Akron because the 8 officers who shot at this man, I don't know, at 90-something times, were let off recently. So there's a lot going on. Yep. I'm not a lawyer. I don't know the law. I cannot foresee any reason why the police would need to get in somebody's car and drive it away and put it somewhere. I'll just leave it at that.
Yeah, just weird and seemingly unnecessary, possibly criminal.